I spoke to my husband. I said, we need to do this. And he's kind of looking at me like, right, okay, why? And I'm going, because cats. My name's Tracy and I own Purple Cat Cafe in Glasgow. The idea started out in Taiwan in the 1980s and I first heard of it, it'll be almost 3 years ago now, when a friend of mine had put a picture of herself and her daughter on Facebook visiting a cat cafe. I hadn't ever heard of them, and the minute I discovered it was a thing, I went, oh my God, I need this. Does Glasgow have one? No, okay, let's just make that happen. Most of the cats have come from somewhere where they weren't allowed to be anymore or able to be anymore. We've, you know, rehomed them and given them a forever home. So we currently have 29 cats living here in the cafe. The smallest cats are 18 and a half weeks, and the oldest cats are in their late teens. They're twice rescued, so their history's not great. Back in early 2018, we had these horrible snowstorms. The high street stores were all closing. Big stores that never close were shut and sending their staff home. We don't really work like a normal cafe. We can't just go, okay, it's a bit snowy, let's just shut the doors and, you know, we'll phone you all when we're open again. We came here and we just stayed here for 3 days. We put the big screen on, we watched movies. It was a bit of an adventure, and it was like a proper like 80s montage sleepover type thing. We just slept on sofas, we pulled cushions down, and we got to spend all that time with the cats, so it was really cool. At the beginning, before we had even told people where we were going to be, hundreds, and I mean literally hundreds of people had signed up and paid for membership, and we'd managed to get loads of people signed up to the mailing list, but that's not that hard. That's just, here's my email address. When it comes to them actually putting their money where their mouth is, that's where you get your real investment. That's where you get people are actually on board with us. And honestly, see the day we launched the memberships, and I seen the numbers of people that had signed up and paid for something that they weren't even 100% sure of where it was going to be. They just knew they wanted to have it. It was a proper, it was a real, one of those ah moments where you go, I'm doing the right thing, I'm doing the right thing. And even when it's really tough in here, and we have days where I think, can anything else go wrong? I remember those days. I actually genuinely go back and sit and think, I didn't know what I was doing. I just knew where I was going. I had no idea how to get there. I was doing my absolute best. But there were several hundred people who believed in the idea, they believed in the people behind it. And it's just, it's so encouraging. When you're having a rubbish day, you think, these people are here.